Welcome back to another episode of Motivation Monday. First of all, let me just thank you all for the support you gave to this channel during the month of February, where we had the relationship series. As you can see, today I do not have a guest. Last week was the final Monday that we had a guest on the show, but thank you so much for the support you have shown to this channel. I really, really do appreciate it. For those who are new, my name is Jane. Karibu sana. Welcome to my channel, where I create lifestyle vlogs and motivation videos. So on today's episode, which is more like a culmination of our relationship series or what we discussed, I just wanted to share ways you can prepare for marriage, or if you're in a serious relationship, or if you're dating and you'd like to get into marriage, then maybe five ways that you can prepare for this. And this is just from my little experience that I have, and I do hope that you get to gain from the points that I share this morning. So while growing up, we have this ideology of what a relationship or a marriage should be or look like, and so we have this picture created in our minds where we just wait for the Prince Charming to come and sweep us off our feet, or also reverse for the guys. But I personally, from my experience, think that it's important to prepare for a relationship, a serious relationship, or marriage in this case. And there are ways in which you can prepare yourself separately as an individual before you get into a partnership with someone. And so those are the points that I'm going to be sharing in this episode today. So the first one is, of course, I have my pointers, evaluate your habits. So there are habits as individuals we are comfortable with, we are used to, and we we really don't want to change because we have found comfort in such habits. And such things will cause, you might find, will be a rift in your relationship or in your marriage as you prepare yourself. This could be things like, maybe let me take for example, if you are a guy or a gentleman and you do like going out, let's say every day of the week, Monday to Monday, while as a bachelor that is okay, when you're preparing for marriage, you have to be open to the fact that you will not be in the same space. And so now you have to be able to compromise on such activities. You should be able to now separate family time from time spending with your friends, from time you spend with going out, from time you spend doing your own other co-curricular activities. You have to be able to evaluate such habits, like be able to be open to change, because now you have a new responsibility that you need to take up. To even for the women, if you're used to going out with your friends every day, if there's a certain habit that you're used to that you know definitely will have to change when you get married, you have to prepare yourself for it even before you start getting into a serious relationship, because such habits are what end up being an issue or what end up causing conflict while inside a marriage or while inside a serious relationship that is leading to marriage. The other one is fine-tune your conflict resolution style. So this one, I would love to use my own personal experience. When it came to handling conflict, I was stuck in my ways, and my ways were not healthy, because it meant that if I was angry or if there was a conflict, I would shut down or shut off and decide that I do not want to talk about it. And that would drag over a week, 2 weeks, a month, which of course causes more and more conflict, or just creates a very weird strain in your relationship or in your marriage. So you want to be able to evaluate your conflict resolution style and be willing to compromise. So like in my case, I had to learn to handle issues faster to be able to skip that conflict and move on with life, as opposed to leaving it to boil inside of me for a long time, which in the process ends up affecting how you relate with your partner. So when you are a bit more flexible in how you handle your conflicts or how you do things, so that you're not stuck, you're willing to compromise a bit to be able to accommodate your partner, I think it really, really helps in how you continue to relate in your marriage. So the other point is learn not to take yourself too seriously. And I think this is a very important thing to really consider or to start preparing yourself for before getting into a serious relationship or into marriage, because a lot of us are stuck in how we do things. And if maybe you're the kind of person who edges more on the perfectionist side, there is a way you're used to doing things. You're used to having breakfast at 7 a.m. and if it comes at 7:30, then that's an issue. You're used to, showering with hot water. So if there's been complications in the morning and you have to use cold water, then that becomes a problem. So I think the point here is learn not to take yourself too seriously, because life has a lot of adjustments that you need to really be able to be flexible to take them up. And it's not even in marriage, I think generally just in life, if we take ourselves too seriously, we end up being stressed and being unhappy and just creating an environment where there's no happiness, just because things have not worked out the way we wanted them to. And that will happen in marriage, you know, especially when kids come, things are going to change, your schedule is definitely going to be affected. So if you are stuck on taking yourself too seriously, you will find that you're always angry over things that you really do not have to be angry about. So just be adjustable, be able to take correction lightly, not carry it with a heavy heart. Just be able to get ideas from your partner as well, because you might be doing something that has been working for you for a long time, but if your partner is suggesting otherwise, it does not mean that you cannot take it up, or you have to take it up as a correction, or you have to think that this person thinks you don't know what they're doing and so now they're correcting you and showing you how to do it. I think also over time, just learn to not take yourself too seriously so that you're a bit more flexible in accommodating your partner. The other one is seek out opportunities to serve. I think sometimes I feel like when we get into relationships, we tend to overburden our partner because we want to spend 100% time with them. We want them to be available when we want them to be available. We want them to be the everything and anything around us, and that tends to be a burden to your partner. So you want to seek opportunities of service that are giving you, like, you're able to do things away from your partner that still give you satisfaction, and that way your partner does not feel overburdened with the responsibility of making sure you're happy, you're satisfied, you are, when, like, you're, they beckon on your call, I don't know if that's how it's said, but like they're not constantly feeling like they have to overburden themselves with the responsibility of making you happy. So when you get opportunities to serve, you're also able to have your own separate time where you do things that you love that do not necessarily include your partner in the picture. The other one is, of course, take a friendship inventory. When it comes to friends, it's very easy to probably get married and be in a circle of friends who do not understand that there are going to be changes that will come with you getting married or with you getting into a partnership with someone else. And so be able to evaluate your friendship inventory and know that there are friends who will most likely not support this, your big change, because it's a big change. Your priorities change. You now have to give more time to your family. And so if you have friends that do not understand that or who are not willing to adjust to the possibility of that change, then you might find that you also struggle to keep those friendships alive when you get married. So it's good to evaluate your friendships if you want to get into a serious relationship or if you want to now get married, because definitely it's going to have an impact on how you relate with your friends after that commitment. The other one is premarital counseling. I think premarital counseling will most likely come when you're in a partnership so that you can do it together. But I also think that it's important to have counseling or have a therapy sessions by yourself, if you know that you're dealing with childhood traumas or things that you know for sure will affect your marriage if you get into them without having healed. So it's important to do therapy sessions. It's important to seek counseling sessions even while by yourself before you get into a partnership or into a marriage, because you're able to deal with those traumas and you're able to not present them as another burden that you're putting on top of your partner, because partnership is meant to make things lighter and not heavier. The last point, of course, is communicate your love language. I think for example, if I was to use my example, as much as I knew that there are things I loved, I honestly don't even think I knew my love language when I was getting married. And that is something that's very, very important, especially when getting into a relationship. It doesn't even have to be marriage. Even if you're just starting to date, it's very important to communicate your love language. And I'm going to just read out the 5 love languages that we have. Number one, these words of affirmation. If you like being affirmed, make sure you communicate that to your partner. There's quality time. You know, if you like your partner to listen better, to spend more time with you, you have to communicate that. Receiving gifts. Some of us, as much as we give gifts, our love language is receiving gifts from our partner. Acts of service. If you need support, maybe around housework or just around things that you do together, it's very important that you communicate that to your partner. Don't just assume that they should know how they should support you or how they should help you. And the last one, of course, is physical touch. If you know that that's important to you, then you need to communicate that to your partner. As when you start getting into your relationship or when you get into a marriage, it's very important to communicate your love language, because what ends up happening is there are expectations you have in your heart, and because you have not communicated those to your partner, then you keep getting angry because you feel like they are intentionally not paying attention to you, they are intentionally not buying you gifts, but they do not know that these are the things that satisfy you or speak to your heart as a love language. So it's very important to communicate your love language to your partner, and this can be as early as dating, so that your partner would be able to now get used to the idea that these are the things that make you happy or these are the things that they need to do to support you. So that goes both ways. I really do hope that you have learned something from our topic today, and I am just sending my love and prayers to everyone and anyone who's looking for a partner, who's in a partnership that will, you're hoping and praying that will lead to a serious commitment like marriage. And I pray for all of us who are in our marriages and who are continuing to work hard to make it better, that we will be able to even use these same steps to continue making our marriages special and keeping them alive. Yeah. That's it for today's video, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you have learned something today. If you're new, karibu sana. Please consider hitting the subscribe button and joining the growing family. And see you guys in the next video. Bye.